Today I'm going to show you how to install a 3M Crimplok Plus connector. This is a filled terminated connector that where the fiber travels all the way through the connector, and then with our tooling you push the fiber back and then lock the fiber in place. With that you also have to polish, and this is our polishing tool. This is called the 3M Nano Polisher. Since the fiber travels all the way through the connector, it has to be polished, but your cleave is flat. So we have to remove part of that material so the fiber angle matches the angle of the fiber ferrule, or the connector ferrule. To open it, you press the side lever here and lift up. If you watch, I will push this button, and as I turn the hand grip underneath, the table is going to spin in one direction while it goes and travels in a different direction. And I spin this until it locks. The button goes back to the reset. The connector itself is a one-piece connector, and it includes a 2-micron polishing film. And I will place this on the table, like so. It's a wet polish, so I'll take a spray and give 2 sprays to the lapping film. That tool is ready to go. I take the connector, and like I said before, it does not have any loose parts. It's just a dust cap. So you remove the dust cap. You will take the assembly tool base, which has the green lever, and you place the connector with the red or white bar upward into the coupling. Lock that into place. Now we have to thread the fiber into the protrusion tool. Since I've already cleaved this fiber at 24 millimeter because it's 900 micron, I'm ready to go. But if you're using 250 micron, please cleave that at 19 millimeters. The way to lace this into the tool is to first start at the bottom and hold at the bottom and close the first door. The first door has a latch, but we're not going to latch it right now. We'll latch it in a second. The other 2 doors, I'm just going to close like that just to rest the fiber inside the track. Now, because the fiber has a plastic coating on it, it's going to have a natural bend. So I'm going to determine where the natural bend is, and I want it to bend downward. And then I'm going to pull this back until the fiber cleaved end is at the tip of the tool. This slides here, so I want that fully extended. And then I slide this in and lock it in place with the latch on this side. That latch goes down and around. I then take the other part of the assembly tool, which has the connector. You can rest this on the table if you'd like, or you can hold it in your hand. You take this and slide this in, and you're going to get a bend. Now you're going to ask, why am I getting this bend? Well, this fiber has been locked in place with the protrusion tool. It can't go backwards. It travels inside the connector, and there's a funnel that tapers down inside the connector, and the funnel stops the 900 micron from proceeding forward. However, your fiber, which has been cleaved at 24 millimeter, has now traveled all the way through the connector. Right now, there's about a whisker stub just outside that connector. I need to push that back. So what I'm going to do is grab this arm, bring this up slowly. When I get past 90 degrees, I will start pushing that fiber back, and that means that little bend there will increase. The flashlight is used to see the fiber. If you push the flashlight and you looked inside, you would see the fiber stub sticking out. As I grab this, I push this forward, and you watch the bend, and you'll see that the bend just moved. I lock down, pushing down, on that red cap. That is our fiber lock technology. Fiber locks have been around for about 25 years. Basically, fiber lock is a piece of an alloy folded into a V. The fiber travels into the bottom, the cap comes down, and it grabs the glass, and it gives you about 2.5 pounds of pullout. But we can also add to the pullout strength by pushing this lever in here and pressing and holding. I then take these wings, move them up about 1/8 of an inch, and that puts a ring over a spring. And now I have over 5 pounds of pullout strength for the connector. I unlatch, pull the protrusion tool out, pull the connector out, place this into the coupling that's on top of the polishing tool, push the button, and I want one consistent, slow polish speed. Never stopped, just one consistent speed. And I've just polished the connector. I then take a lint-free and wipe it down. The 3M Crimplok Plus connector has been out for 2.5 years and has had received market acceptance from key accounts as well as other major accounts. It's unique in that the fiber travels all the way through the connector. You are not burning a pigtail on. You are not using a no polish type of connector where you have index matching gel or fiber stub. It's your fiber talking to your fiber. And that's the importance of the 3M connector. Please click the link below for more information.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and check the links below for more information on the product and to subscribe to our monthly newsletter.